I've been into sports actually all my life. I started at a center for social and mental disabled people. I'm born there, not because my parents are mental disabled, but my father was working for a huge organization, and we had a house there. So I grew up with like 1,000 people who are not able to participate like we do in society. And what we saw over there, what I saw as a small kid when I was 8, it was a miserable atmosphere, actually. People were like in prison, and just they were kept there, and they couldn't come out, and there was just a very negative sphere. And what my brother and I always did was playing football, or just shooting the ball to each other. And when I was 8, 9, there were a few guys who were living there. They asked us, can we join you? Can we play with you? And from that point, we saw a sort of change in the whole atmosphere of this center, because people would like to join us. In the end, we made 5 teams of all different kind of players, which was a huge success. And in the end, when we moved there, I tried to get those people, make them a member of the football club in Woudenberg, the place where my parents live. So that worked very good. And what I saw there is that there are a lot of people in Holland, but I'm sure in the rest of the world as well, who are not able to participate in the normal sports infrastructure we have. So that's why we started last year a special foundation which focused on the social role of sports. What does it mean for social excluded people, like homeless people or mental disabled people, to participate in sport projects, in grassroots projects, like you told? So that's what we do, and one of our main items or main projects is the Dutch Homeless Cup. Like Dr. Hill told, there is an international platform, and we are organizing in Holland a national competition for this this target group. Well, I'll just take you through some pictures about football, and furthermore the social role of football. This happens in Holland after the last final, World Cup final last year. It's unbelievable. More than a million people at the Dam Square. We became second at the World Cup. But there, what you see is football unites people. It really brings people together. But football works in another way as well. You see here, this little boy. But we also have a project which is called Grandfather Football in Holland, or Opa Football, which is, this is the goalie, Rinus. He is 94 years old, and he was sitting on a stair, which was not a stair, but it was made from beer, you know, where you drop all the beers in. So he was just sitting there waiting for a ball. He had a lovely time. This is in the Olympic Stadium in Amsterdam, which was used during the Olympics in 1928. But there is also, and we're very happy to see that, a social role for football players. This is Edgar Davis in one of our projects, telling children about living on a healthy way. The project is called Scoring for Health. And what we're doing is bring kids, 1,000 kids each club in Holland, and educate them about what to eat. It's not good to have breakfast with chips, or eat peanuts during lunch, but eat some vegetables. Well, this works amazingly. The impact of those players, those role models, are enormous. Well, and then 3 years ago, I met Mel. Mel is the president of the Homeless World Cup. He started an international event, and Mel is a journalist, and he visited a lot of congresses like this. And what he said in the end, well, it's very nice to speak about very important topics, but it's more important that we start working on such issues. And what he did is just organize a tournament, a Homeless World Cup, he called it. The first one was in Graz in 2003, and just being in Rio de Janeiro last year, for me it's also a perfect job because there's also a bit of a combination between holiday and working at the Copacabana beach, you can imagine. But it's a rising star. This is during the finals in Melbourne 2 years ago. It's Federation Square. I think 6,000-7,000 people are watching homeless people playing football, but playing perfect football. It was Afghanistan against Russia, the final. It was live broadcasted in Russia. In Russia. So that means how important this event is. Well, what we do in Holland is a national competition. So we have a kind of selection procedure to reach the final, the champion of the national competition, reach the Homeless World Cup. We play with guys like this. This is a team from Maastricht Heerlen, which are all drugs and alcohol abused people living in miserable circumstances, but feeling so happy and so proud that they are a member of a team, that they have a role. Some of them are not really able to play football because of their drugs and alcohol abuse of the last couple of years. But just being involved into a team, being part, just bring the water to the pitch or doing something is really amazing for those guys. And it really works in their participation and reintegration trajectory. And that's what we always try to use sport as a tool to become fitter or to become mental better. Well, these are the partners we have in Holland. You see, these are all very professional partners, so it's not like a volunteer project, but it's really a project with professional partners like the Salvation Army, who is our network to the players, of course, but also the Ministry of Wellbeing and Sports is involved into this program. This is the mayor of Amsterdam, Mr. van der Laan, with the director of the Salvation Army last year during the finals. And this is one of our star players. Who knows these guys? Jacques Vart. Jacques Vart and?
Frans
Derks. Yeah. Those are, Jacques Vart is a legendary football player from Ajax during the glory times of Ajax in the 1970s. And the other guy is Frans Derks, who was a famous referee in that period. Both ambassadors of this project. Well, some facts about the impact, what we did last year, only in Holland. We had like 1,500 participants, players selected in shelter organizations involved into this project. We have 20 cities involved right now. And there is, like you just saw, a national podium. Once a year, we build this huge huge tent at the Dam Square in Amsterdam. But more important, 92% of the participants find new motivation in life. 73% changes lives on a structural way. So that means less alcohol or get rid of alcohol, find a job. And that's 35% of the participants find a job after this project. Ambitions? Well, of course, we want to organize the Homeless World Cup once. We have a target now in 2015, but we want to spread this project. We see that the power of combining or to set up local networks, to combine a sports organization with a shelter organization, works perfectly. So that's what we're going to do the next couple of years. And this is just the final pick of the winning team last year, The Hague, who played at the Homeless World Cup in Rio. Well, thanks.
Thank you.